Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to talk about the paddle shifters of Honda City 2020 5th generation CVT model. We have received lots of comments from you guys and we try to make and cover the topics what you guys select. So today's topic will be the paddle shifters and the wait is over. The paddle shifters on this car are really useful in CVT model. If you want to drive fast, if you want to drive manually, you can do that with this car in the CVT model as well. You get two paddle shifters here with this minus here and plus over here. So this on the left is the minus and plus you get it here. I don't think I have to explain you that what is minus and plus for. To downshift you press minus and to shift up you have to press on plus sign. Right now I'm driving in the D mode. If you check here we have two modes. The first P, R and N, you already know that this is parking, reverse and neutral. This is D for the drive mode and S for the sports mode. Right now we are driving in the drive mode, and as you know that in the drive mode most of the cars cannot do paddle shiftings directly. Even in this car as well, it's not completely manual when you drive in the drive mode. You have to drive in the sports mode to make it more functional and more dynamic if you want to use complete manual shiftings on this particular car. For example, if I'm driving in D mode right now and if I want to overtake someone, I can just use that for the paddle shifting for plus and minus, just for the fraction of seconds, for 5 seconds or so, and it will automatically change the gear. The car will automatically change the gear depending on my speed. So let's see. As of now, you see the D, which is the drive mode. I'm gonna shift the paddle to minus and we'll go to the third gear. I'm driving in the third gear right now and the third gear will disappear when I speed up my car. For example, if I lower my gear to third again and I'm driving above 50 and I'm going above 60, it automatically changes my gear to the fourth, because depending on my speed it will change the gears and will, I do not have full control on the paddle shifters when I'm driving in the D mode. So that's how the paddle shifter works on these cars. So guys, as you have seen that in D mode I have a lesser control on the car, but for example if I go on the sports mode and I'm shifting right now this gear mode transmission to the sports mode, as you see here, and if we come back on the screen you will see that I'm driving in the sports mode. It says sports. You have more control over your car in terms of speed, the RPM and everything. You can control yourself and you can actually drive or experience driving the car completely manual. So without this paddle shifters, the sports mode won't be much useful because it happens automatically. You don't have more control. When you have more control over your automatic car, then there is nothing best than that. So Honda cars has done a great job, made these paddle shifters and the sports mode, and you can go from 0 to 100 in less than 10 seconds in this particular car. Let's see how. So if I'm driving in right now, I'm driving at I don't know what gear it is right now, but 2930 is my KMH right now, and I'm gonna shift the gear and shift up the gear from here. Let's shift the gear manual 3. Now this manual 3, I've completely changed it to manual and it won't go away like in the drive mode. I'm driving in the third gear and I'll stay on the third gear till I shift my paddle shifters from. So let's see, and I'm accelerating right now, downshifting the gear to 2. Look at this. On the second gear, I'm gonna cross 80, 90, shifting to the 3, and my RPM is more than 5000, and I'm driving a 3 at 115, 17, 21, 23. This is amazing. You have complete control over this car. I'm driving on 5th gear and the RPM goes down. You have complete control on this car, and that gives you a serious feeling when you drive this car. The Japanese has done a great job building this car, making this sports mode available on this Honda City with the paddle shifters and the Dream Earth engine. You can feel the Dream Earth engine platform when you're driving the sports mode with the manual shifters on. I'm driving in the 5th right now, at a normal pace, once I have a low traffic, I'll show you again how this works, and we will see the speed of this car in the manual. Alright guys, so we are standing still at a position. The car is in sports mode. I'm gonna turn it to manual 1. Alright, and now we're gonna see 0 to 100 how much second it takes in the sports mode. So let's go. 3, 2, 1, go. The noise of this engine is so satisfying. When it's a humming sound comes out of the sports mode, you can feel the engine right there and the performance. Let's downshift to 3. The RPM is 5000. We've crossed 140. And I have to break it because of this traffic. Alright, so as you have seen the performance of this car, make sure guys the mileage of this car will go down when you drive like this for sure. But this is just for the testing. And whenever you're in hurry, you can definitely try this. I'm gonna put back in the D mode and the eco mode is right there. You can see the green on the speedometer, on the digital meter, that you can see the green what I'm back to eco, where your mileage recovers back. So whenever you are in hurry or you're testing the car, the engine, if you want to test it out, man, this is the car you want to test. The Dream Earth engine platform, the Honda City, the Japanese. I just want to kiss those Japanese on the forehead to build this particular car, and they have done a great job. Alrighty guys, thank you so much for watching this video. It's time to wrap up. I hope you have liked this video. If you did, please give a thumbs up on this video. Please subscribe to the channel if you are new to the channel, and please share this video with as many as people possible. If you have anything in mind, if you want to know about the cars, any questions you have, please write in the comment box, and I'll make sure that we make that video or you get your questions answered in the rightly manner. So thank you so much for supporting guys. I know you always support me, and that this is a big thumbs up and a thank you for you guys that you have kept supporting me and in my previous videos, and you have liked a lot of videos and you've shared my videos. So thank you so much and keep doing that. Your support is really important to me. Thank you so much guys, and see you in the next one. Till then, see you. So guys, we are standing still at a position. We're gonna test out the 0 to 100 on this car in the sports mode. Let's turn to manual 1 and 3, 2, 1, go.